shake my nerves and rattle my brain. Too much love drives a man insane. You broke my will, but what a thrill. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. Got it.
Old Testament Book of Psalms is a book of worship, with text covering the gamut of human emotions and experiences. Composers from many time periods and genres have set many of the psalms to music. Tonight, we present the Symphony of Psalms 23. Referred to as the Psalm of David, this text is undoubtedly one of the most utilized and familiar. Tonight's Symphony of Psalms 23 selections begin with a rendition by British composer Howard Goodall, which became popular as the theme song for BBC's Vicar of Dibley. The second setting, in Hebrew, is from the Symphony of Psalms by Latvian composer Imam Ramesh, followed by the famous arrangement included in John Clutter's Requiem. The final version is the second movement from the great American composer Leonard Bernstein's Chichester Psalms. The tranquil melody is abruptly interrupted by the men's voices and the textual insertion of the second psalm. Interestingly, the first theme was adapted from a musical that Bernstein never completed, The Skin of Our Teeth, based on a play by Gordon Wilder. The men's theme, from material that was cut out of West Side Story, ladies and gentlemen, a Symphony of Psalm 23.
Thank you. widely considered one of America's greatest songwriters in history, Irving Berlin published his first song in 1907 and had his first major international hit. Alexander's ragtime band, 1911, sparking an international dance craze. During his 60-year career, he wrote an estimated 1,500 songs, including a score for 19 Broadway shows and 18 Hollywood films, with his songs nominated 8 times for Academy Awards. Composer George Gershwin, no slouch himself, called him, quote, the greatest songwriter that has ever lived. And composer Jerome Kern concluded that, quote, Irving Berlin has no place in American music. He is American music. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Irving Berlin's America.
Thank you. Continual Arts launched a Conducting Fellows program to give a platform and hands-on experience to emerging young conductors. We have been privileged to work with three outstanding young artists, and we would like to take a moment to recognize them and to thank them for their contributions. Stephanie Harris.
Thanksgiving that we welcome the St. James the Apostle choir members.